Hi, this is Asghar Gauri, and today I'm going to show you how to monitor user login and system restart activities on the Linux system. I'll talk about the simple commands that we can use to display the desired information and the files that these commands reference. For the demonstration portion of this video, I'll be using my CentOS 7 system called Server 1. Before we proceed, please note that this talk applies to other major Linux distributions as well. However, the file names and their locations might vary from one distribution to another and from one Linux version to another. For more information on Linux, including exam preparation details for the Red Hat Certified Systems Administrator, Red Hat Certified Engineer, and CompTIA Linux Plus powered by Linux Professional Institute, see my latest publications shown on this slide that are available on major online retailers and app stores. By default, Linux keeps track of users that are currently logged on to the system. It maintains a history of all previous successful and unsuccessful user login attempts, and it also maintains a history of all system reboots that have occurred in the past. Moreover, it keeps a record of the most recent login attempt by each individual user. This information may be used for system and security audit purposes. As part of this accounting and maintenance, Linux records crucial data for each activity, and it stores that data in various log files. As part of this accounting and maintenance, Linux records crucial data for each activity, and it stores that data in various log files. These log files are non-readable, which means that we cannot read what they contain using the standard text file viewing tools such as the cat command, the more command, the less command, and so on. However, Linux does offer a range of other utilities that can read the contents of these log files, extract what we desire to see, and show us the results. The first item on our list is on how to view the users that are currently logged on to the system. The information relevant to the logged in users is stored in a file called utmp, which is located under /var/run. This file is updated whenever a user logs into or logs out of the system. The information collected in this file includes the login name of the user, the associated terminal identifier, the hostname or IP address where the user is connected from, the time of logging in, the time that the user has been idle for, the CPU time consumed by all the processes associated with the user's terminal identifier, the CPU time that is used by the current process only, and the name of the process. The process here means any program or command that the user is running. The UTMP file also maintains the system boot timestamp information, which includes the current system time, the length of time the system has been up for, a count of the users that are logged on, and an estimate of the average CPU performance over the past 1, 5, and 15 minutes. Since this file is located under /var/run, which is used by Linux to store a portion of the runtime information of the system, its contents are destroyed at system shutdown and repopulated with new data when users begin to log on after a system reboot. This file stores the data in a non-text format, and therefore Linux provides us the commands such as who, w, and uptime to read and understand that data and display it to us. An important point I'd like to highlight here is that the commands I've just mentioned may also refer to other system runtime data that is maintained at other directory locations, such as the /proc file system. Let's now run the who command without any options and see what it reports. The login names in the first column, the device file for this terminal in the second column, the date and time when the user logged on in the next columns, and the IP address or the host name of the remote system where the user has connected from in the last column. You may see in the second column terminal device files such as TTY or PTS followed by a digit. TTY represents the text screen opened on a non-graphical system console, and PTS identifies the sudo or virtual terminal screen that is opened on the graphical desktop or for a remote connection. and the digits 0, 1, 2, and so on that are suffixed with them represent a connection number. For instance, the next users who would log on would get pts/1, pts/2, pts/3, and so on and so forth. The colon 0 in the second column means that the user has logged on to the graphical desktop. And the colon 0 in the last column tells us that the user is running a graphical terminal session. And here is what the W command reports. There is a system uptime information on the first line, which includes the current system time, the length of time since the system was last restarted, a count of the users that are currently signed on, and the CPU load performance for the past 1, 5, and 15 minutes. The subsequent rows under the header line in uppercase letters show the user login name in the first column, the terminal identifier in the second column, the login time, the idle time in seconds, minutes, hours, or days in the fourth column, the CPU time taken by all the processes associated with the terminal, and the CPU time consumed by this particular process, which is reported in the last column. On some Linux distributions and versions, you may see an IP address or the host name of the remote system the user is connected from in an additional column. And here's the uptime command output, which basically shows what the W command reports in the first line of its output. The who, W, and the uptime commands have limited options available with them that you can use to modify what you would want to see in the output. Check out their manual pages for details. The next item on our list is on how to view the history of successful user logins and previous system reboots. The information relevant to these activities is stored in the wtmp file, which is located in the /var/log directory. The data collected in this file includes the user login name, the terminal identifier, the IP address or the host name of the remote system, or whether the terminal session is running on the graphical desktop, the login and logout timestamps, the duration of the entire login session, and whether the user is still logged in. Most of this information is transferred from the UTMP file. The data in the WDMP file is also stored in the non-text format, which can be read, understood, and displayed with the use of a command called last. Let's run this command here. As you can see on the screen, it reports the username in the first column, followed by the terminal ID in the second column, host name, IP address, or the graphical information in the third column, login and logout timestamps, or whether the user is still logged on in the subsequent columns, and the duration of the login session. On Linux systems running the NORM Desktop Manager or GDM, you may also see login entries associated with unknown accounts. These entries are generated and placed in the WTMP file by GDM. This is a known bug and you should ignore these entries. In addition to maintaining the user login history data, the WTMP file also registers previous system reboot events. And as part of it, it records the kernel version that was running when the system was booted up, the time at which the system was shut down, and the duration of the time the system remained operational. For the current system boot event, it calculates the system operational time up to the current time. So in the highlighted line here, The system was booted up at 10:25, November 21st, Tuesday, and 11:38 is the current time. The system has been up for 1 hour and 13 minutes. The last command has a few options available that you can use to modify its behavior. Check out the command's manual pages for details. The third item on our list is on how to view the history of unsuccessful user login attempts. These failed user login attempts might be due to incorrect password submission or some other similar issue. The information relevant to this activity is stored in a file called btmp, which is also located in the central log directory /var/log. The data collected in this file includes the same information that is recorded in the WTMP file for successful attempts. This data is also stored in a non-text format, which can be read, understood, and displayed with the use of a command called lastb, which is a variant of the last command that we have just used. Unlike the last command that can be run by the normal users, the lastb command must be run with the root user privileges, as the btmp file is only readable by the root user. Here's a listing of the file that indicates the permissions on it. Now let's change into the root user account and run the lastb command. And pipe the output to more. As you can see on the screen, the command reports the username in the first column, followed by the terminal ID, hostname, IP, graphical, session information, timestamp for the attempt, and the duration for the attempt in the last column. The SSH colon no TTY entries in the second column identify that these attempts were from remote systems using the SSH protocol and that they failed, and therefore no terminal IDs were assigned to them. The lastb command shares most of the options that are available with the last command. View the command's manual pages for details on the usage. And the last item for discussion in this video is on viewing the most recent successful login attempt for each individual user account, including the root user, all normal users that are defined on the system, and all service user accounts that are on the system. The information relevant to this activity is stored in a file called lastlog, which is also located in the central log directory /var/log. The data collected in this file includes the user login name, a terminal identifier, the IP address or the host name of the remote system, and the timestamp for the attempt. This data is also recorded in a non-text format, which can be read, understood, and displayed with the use of a command called lastlog. The command name and the file name are identical. Let's run this command. This command does not require root user privileges for execution. So let's log out as root and go back to user 1 and run this command. The output indicates the username in the first column, terminal or port identifier in the second column, hostname or IP address in the third column, and the time for the latest attempt. The users that have never logged in are typically the service user accounts. There are certain options available with the lastlog command that you can use to control what you want to see in the output. Check out the command's manual pages for details. Now that you have learned the basics of Linux accounting log files and the commands to view them, try these commands on your system and observe the outputs. This brings us to the conclusion of this video. If you like this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up, provide feedback, subscribe to channel NixEducation, and share this video with your friends and colleagues. Thank you for watching. Bye now.